Welcome back to Living Local. If you enjoy entertaining, you're probably familiar with charcuterie boards. They're piled high with cured meats, cheeses, crackers, fruit, nuts, and more. They're super versatile and offer guests a variety of flavors and textures to snack on at gatherings and parties. Joining me today is Taylor Jamison with Plate Me Quad Cities, or Plate Me QC. What is your experience in hospitality, Taylor?
Yeah, I worked in the restaurant industry on and off for over 10 years. I started off waitressing when I was at Illinois State University. When I moved back home to the Quad Cities, I've worked on and off as a bartender at several different establishments.
Nice. Now, this is such a beautiful arrangement you shared with us today. You also have a master's degree in health sciences. How does that education play out in the work that you do with Plate Me QC?
Yeah, my master's degree in health science has a focus on public health, which I feel like is really valuable right now as we're living through a pandemic. Yeah. Infection prevention and following safety protocols are always my number one concern while I'm making the trays and interacting with my customers.
That's always comforting to know when you're handling food. Everyone's going to be eating, because a lot of these are finger foods.
Yes.
And you'll have to roll them up with your hands. And yeah, right. So those are really important. What inspires your passion for food and entertaining?
Yeah, I've always been somewhat of a foodie. And I love having my family and friends over and hosting them in my home. And I just enjoy like taking care of people, making them happy, and I feel like food is an easy way to do that.
Yeah, absolutely. So what got you interested in making charcuterie trays in particular?
Well, I've been interested in charcuterie trays for a few years, and simply just because I think they're both delicious and beautiful.
Yeah, they really are. We can just smell the aroma in the studio here today, and it's making everyone hungry. What makes charcuterie trays a great option for entertaining or just for any occasion?
Yeah, I think charcuterie boards are good for entertaining because you can have them ready ahead of time and simply just take them out of your fridge whenever your guests arrive. I also think that they're kind of a fun thing to have when you have guests over, company over, because you can talk about all the different components and how to make the perfect bite, mixing everything together, or your guests might have not tried a different variety of the cheeses.
Yeah.
And it's funny that you ask about what occasion they're good for, because I have a lot of people that say, oh, I want to order, but I'm waiting for an event to come up. But you can really enjoy a charcuterie board any day of the week or just on a lazy Sunday at home.
So what gives you the idea of pairing these? Like, what would be a great pair of food varieties between the meat and the fruits? You have nuts, olives, so there's lots of flavors going on there. What's a good pairing for some of these?
Well, I think it's kind of fun to mix things together, like mix a spicy with the sweet and different textures, maybe like a soft with a crunchy cracker or something like that.
Yeah, yeah. What cheeses do you find are often the most popular that people are surprised by that maybe they don't usually try?
Yeah, maybe I like the goat cheeses. This one is a vanilla goat cheese with
the
blueberry.
Is that this one right here?
The
blueberry. I bet that would be nice.
Yeah, it's good. Yeah, I like it when they're a little bit different, unique.
Yeah, with the blueberry. So what kind of meat would you end up pairing that with the blueberry?
I would try one of the salamis, probably.
Okay.
Yeah.
So yeah, so normally I thought of charcuterie, and I'm like, okay, it's going to be like cheese and sausage.
Right.
And you brought this out, and I thought, oh my gosh, I've not seen anything like this extravagant before when it comes to charcuterie. So this is really a beautiful setting.
Thank you.
What tips can you offer anyone who's wanting to build a charcuterie tray at home?
I would say first to get quality ingredients. Then next, I like to take my time and cut the cheese into different shapes and fold the meats different ways and paying attention to the little details.
Is that rose easier to make?
Some practice.
I mean, that's where I'm going. Maybe I'm just overshooting on that one, and I'm an overachiever, but I'm like, ooh, a pretty rose. How do I do that?
Yep. There's YouTube.
YouTube. Yes. Okay, that's really helpful. And if people want a pro to take over, what kinds of trays and sizes do you offer at Plate Me QC? Yes.
The trays can be somewhat time-consuming,
yes.
So I would love to do the work for you if you ever would like a charcuterie tray. The trays that I use are biodegradable. You can recycle them when you're done. I really love using sustainable products whenever I can. My trays come in a few different sizes. There's large. This is a large here. There's also medium and small trays, and then I do gift boxes and individual plates for like a work luncheon as well.
Oh, that's great. So yeah. You can serve large or small audiences and really make it cost beneficial. Do you use a lot of local products by chance?
I try to whenever I can, yeah.
Yeah, that's great. And it's great for the environment too, that it's more sustainable. Yeah. So how do people pick up their trays?
Yeah, so I arrange with my customers to do pickups in either the Illinois side or Iowa side of the river so I can make it easy and convenient for them.
Oh, right, so you'll just meet them at a location then.
Yep.
That's perfect.
Yep. Just message back and forth and see whatever works for them.
Yeah, that's wonderful. It's especially nice to be flexible when you're entertaining, for sure. Taylor Jamison, Plate Me QC, thank you so much for being on Living Local with us today. For more information, visit platemeqc.com. We'll also have those details posted on our Quad City.